Hi all, today we are going to discuss the interference between the power and communication lines. So let us take for example, I am taking three conductors of a transmission line. Let us assume these conductors are A, B and C. They are kept up the three sides of an equilateral triangle. And let us assume this is my ground. So let us assume a communication line is traveling nearby, because the communication line will have the two conductors, positive and the negative conductor. Let us assume D and E is my communication line. Now what happens? So whatever the electric field is produced by each of these conductors, that whatever the electric field, that electric field will link with these conductors also. So that leads to the effect called as electrostatic effect, or we can tell that that effect, like each of these will form a capacitance or the capacitance effect. And the second one, the flux produced by each of the current passing through these conductors. The current passing through these conductors will produce the flux, that produces the magnetic flux. So that magnetic flux links with these two conductors, that leads to the effect of electromagnetic effect or the inductance effect. So these two are going to create the problem in your communication line. So if a power line is running along the same route as the communication line, there will be an interference in the communication line due to both electromagnetic and electrostatic effect, both magnetic field and static field. So the electromagnetic effect produces the currents which is superimposed on the communication signal, and thereby it gets distorted. That means because of the electromagnetic effect or the magnetic field, the currents are induced in the communication signal. So because of that, they will superimpose with the signal of your communication channel. So your signal get distorted. That means whatever the signal you transmit, that get distorted due to the effect of electromagnetic effect. Now coming to the electrostatic effect or effect of the capacitance, the electrostatic effect induces voltage in the communication line. So because of induction of the voltage in the communication line, the voltage in the communication line will get increased. Because of this, it may be dangerous in handling the telephone receiver, because if this value is go on integrating as you are passing along the length of the line, so it will create the danger to the person who is operating the receiver if it crosses the limit. So both these effects depends on the distance between the power and the communication lines and the root length over which they run in parallel. So it is necessary to ensure that the distortion and the maximum voltage rise are within the limits. So let us see what is the electromagnetic effect. So electromagnetic effect of the line. So let us take for example, I am taking three conductors A. This is A, this is B and this C. So these are my transmission line. Let us assume there is a communication line, that conductors are represented by D and E. Let us assume this is my ground connection. This is my ground connection. So now let D and E, these are the communication channels. So the flux linkages to conductor D due to current in conductor A. Due to the conductor A, what is the effect on this communication conductor D? So that we are seeing. So this can be written as the flux linkages I am representing by lambda due to conductor A on conductor D. So I am writing as lambda AD. This will be equal to 2 into 10 to the power of minus 7 into current passing through the conductor is IA into ln of D infinity, because we have to move from infinity up to the point DAD. You have to move from infinity up to this point AD. So we have already seen in the inductance how these inductance between two conductors will be calculated. So based on that scheme, so where this value of D infinity is the distance of the infinity, that means it is nothing but it will be infinity at that point only the flux lines will be there. We have to move from infinity to this point. So similarly, the flux linkages to conductor E due to conductor A, because conductor A will induce in the conductor B also. So this will be equal to that lambda A in the conductor E or the communication line E will be 2 into 10 to the power of minus 7 into current passing in the conductor is IA into ln of D infinity divided by DAE. In this form I can represent this. So the mutual flux linkages between these conductors D and E, that means I can tell that mutual flux linkages between conductors D and E due to current IA. So this can be written as this lambda AD minus lambda AE. So this I can write as 2 into 10 to the power of minus 7 into IA into ln of, because the difference of these two, so ln of A minus ln of B will be equal to ln of A by B. So this will become equal to DAA divided by DAD if you are just subtracting the above two equations. So from this I can calculate my mutual inductance. So this mutual inductance I can represent due to conductor A in the loop DE. So that I am representing by A. So this is due to A in loop DE. I am providing the complete handwritten material in the description of this video as a Google Drive link. You can download the complete handwritten material from there. Here you try to understand the concept what I am teaching, because once you understand the concept, remaining material for the exam you can refer from there. So here you try to understand the concept clearly. So this will become this flux linkages divided by the current passing through that. So this will become equal to 2 into 10 to the power of minus 7 ln of DAE divided by DAD. So this will be in Henry's per meter. Let us take it as equation number 1. So in the similar way, the mutual inductance MB due to conductor B on this path can be written as 2 into 10 to the power of minus 7 ln of the distance between B to E divided by distance between B to D. These also in Henry's per meter. Similarly, MC also I can write as 2 into 10 to the power of minus 7 ln of DCA divided by DCD. This is in Henry's per meter. Let us take it as equation number 2. So from this I can tell that the net mutual inductance, so let us represent it M. This M will be equal to, this M is the sum of the vector sum of all these things. So this will be MA plus MB plus MC, because these are AC, so we can take this as phasor sum. So this is equation number 3. So if the current that is passing in the conductor, power conductor, let us assume that current I am representing by I. So if the current in power conductor is I and the frequency of supply is, frequency is represented by F, then the voltage that is induced in the communication line between D and E I can represent as J omega into M, because J omega L is a reactance. Because of this reactance, the current that is passing that I induces the voltage. So this much voltage will be induced, this is in volt per meter. This much voltage will be induced. This effect is called as the electromagnetic effect. So because of this voltage that is induced, the current will start passing in the communication line. So that creates the problem in your signal, because your signal got distorted. So the magnitude of flux linkages and this induced EMF mainly depends on whether your current is balanced or unbalanced. Because if your current is balanced, the condition will be different. If the current is unbalanced, the condition will be different. Getting it? So this omega M multiplied by I, so we can represent, because this is the case when the currents are same. So otherwise this will become something like J omega into this M into I. So this M into I becomes this M into, so the, because of the first one, this will become MA into, the value is IA, plus MB into IB, plus MC into IC. It will become like this, because all these are the phasors. So if the currents are different, so in this way it will come. So if you are assuming all the currents are same, then it will become equal to J omega M into I. So I am assuming that is the reason here. So let us see what will be the condition under different type of conditions. So first I am seeing the case of balanced currents. So if you are taking the case of balanced currents means, if you are taking, let us assume the IA as my reference, IA is some value I at an angle of 0 degrees, the value of IB will be I at an angle of minus 120 degrees and IC is equal to I at an angle of minus 240 degrees. This is called positive sequence current. because currents are balanced means only positive sequence current is there. Even if let us assume the negative sequence currents also there, so even in the negative sequence current what happens, Ia is will be equal to I at an angle of 0 degrees, this Ib will be equal to I at an angle of minus 240 degrees and Ic will be equal to I at an angle of minus 120 degrees. This is for negative sequence. This negative sequence current comes whenever there is unbalanced load is connected. That means the currents are different, but actually that negative, that can be resolved into two components. One is a positive sequence component and the negative sequence component. So only if it is associated with the ground, then only the zero sequence current comes. Otherwise only positive and negative sequence component comes. So if you are taking the total effect of this is coming as the sum of the currents are coming here, because we know the currents are displaced by 120 degrees. So automatically the net effect will be equal to 0, because the net effect of this will be nearly equal to 0, because it depends on the value of MA, MB and C, because they may not be exactly equal. That's a little bit value of the current will be induced in the line. So to avoid this, what we can do under balanced current conditions, if you want to nullify this effect, you just transpose your transmission line. That means if you are taking ABC at some point, this is conductor A, B and C, then we will do the transposition of these conductors. So like this transposition, every conductor will occupy the second position. Because of this transposition, so automatically the mutual inductance, because per each area, because this is my telecom line, so the EMF induced up to here will be in 1-1, because mutual reactance is different. So here the mutual inductance is different. So if you are taking as a sum of the whole, if you take the sum, automatically they get balanced and the complete effect will get nullified. So under balanced conditions, there is no problem. Let us see unbalanced currents or the current associated with the ground are connected. That means that I am taking the case of unbalanced currents. So unbalanced currents, let us take for example, I am taking single phase fault. This single phase fault means it will be single phase fault also, there is no problem. It is single phase to ground fault, what I mean to tell, single phase to ground fault. So single phase to ground fault means any one phase is connected to the ground. So in that case, what happens, any fault that is associated with the ground, that involves the zero sequence components. What is the meaning of the zero sequence component? The value of Ia, Ib and Ic will be in phase with each other, because this is a zero sequence component, Ib not, Ic not. These are in phase with each other. Because of this currents, the EMFs are induced. Because of this, the whatever electromagnetic EMFs are induced, the sum will not be equal to zero, because all are in phase with each other. They will add to each other. As they are adding to each other, what will happen? Whatever the EMF are induced, that will be 3 times due to each phase. So this will become 3 times of E due to each phase. So this is EMF induced. In the case of zero sequence component, is it becoming 3 times. So the severity will be very high. So whenever fault comes, the severity becomes very high. There is one more effect that we have seen, that is corona. So because of the corona, the third harmonic components are induced. Because of the third harmonic current, because that is having the triple N frequency. When you are multiplying with the triple N frequency, the third harmonic components we have seen already in the transformers, what will be the effect of the third harmonic? They also will be displaced from each other by 0 degrees. So all the three currents will be in phase with each other. This is for the triple N harmonics. And the second one, the frequency also will be equal to 3 times your fundamental frequency. So this frequency due to corona will be 3 times the frequency. So we can tell the EMF that is induced will be 3 times the EMF per phase. So and frequency also becomes 3 times. So that's why it is becoming nearly equal to 9 times the EMF that can be induced per phase. So this effect is very much severe. So in this case, how to avoid? So in this case, the better solution is, anyway your transmission line is transposed. So transmission line is transposed and this communication line also get transposed. Communication line also transposed. If along with the transmission line, if the communication line also completely transposed, in that case this effect of voltage can be almost nullified completely. So this is the practical way that is employed to avoid the electromagnetic effect. I am just trying to summarize it. Due to electromagnetic effect, the currents will be induced in the line. The amount of the currents depends on what is the voltage that is induced due to the electromagnetic effect. So that is given by voltage V is equal to J omega multiplied by that mutual inductance between, because of the effect of each conductor, multiplied by current passing through that conductor. Like that you have to do the vector sum. If the currents are balanced, in that case the effect will be very less because they are displaced by 120 degrees. So to further make it nearly equal to 0, you have to just transpose your transmission line. But in the case of unbalanced current, that means the currents that involve either zero sequence component currents or the third harmonic component of currents, what we practically employed is you will transpose your telecom line also along with transposition of your transmission line, so that the voltage effect will get nearly nullified, or the voltage effect will get decreased, electromagnetic effect get decreased. I hope what is the effect of electromagnetic effect and how to nullify is clear to you. So in the next class we are going to see how, what is the electrostatic effect and how to make the precautions for decreasing the effect of both electromagnetic effect as well as electrostatic effect in the transmission line. So I hope this is clear to you. If you still have any queries, you can leave your comments in the comment section below. I will answer to your queries from there. Thank you. Thank you very much.